Okay, and the last thing I ordered from rainbowmealworms.com was some hissing cockroaches. Now, I absolutely love hissing cockroaches, mostly because they're huge and they have that trademark hissing. I used to have, the lighting in here is terrible, I do apologize. I used to have a huge colony of them, and when I started working, my job kind of took priority over their care, and I'm ashamed to admit that over the summer with the heat and me working all the time, the colony sadly mostly all died out. In fact, the only ones that I have left are two males. So I ordered 8 females and 2 other males, and I'm going to try to restart my colony. So these are this was what they were shipped in. Let's see. You can see how a lot of these females, which happen to be these guys right here, the ones that don't have a horn. They are big, fat, and plump, which means either they're pregnant or they're producing their little egg case thingamajiggy and they can get pregnant, or they're just really, really well fed. Phoebe is also very, very interested in these hissers. She likes to, the two that I have left, she loves to. Yeah, the hisser just not a big fan of cats, but she likes to, I'm not gonna let her though, but she likes to bat at it and get them to move around, and yeah, so here they are in the container they were shipped in. I'm going to put them in a container and just here in a second. And if this one looks familiar, it's because it's the same container I used to put the superworms in after I got them out of the bag. I cleaned it out with some warm soapy water, and I'm not going to bother with putting a layer of Vaseline on the edges, because I've done that in the past and it just makes a big nasty mess. And my husband actually found an alternative. Let me grab it real quick. Here's the lid. What he did was he got some insulation foam, or not the foam, but you know, the stuff that you put in your windows, and he attached it to the corners, and it kept out a lot of the little teeny tiny babies. The adults you don't have to worry about so much, it's the little babies. But this one's old because this was the one I first started out with when I had my colony from the beginning, and it's kind of aged, but it's still good. I'm going to probably eventually put them in a container that's covered up because they prefer it to be a little bit dark rather than bright. So I'm going to put some Eco Earth here in a second and then transfer them over. So I dumped in some Eco Earth that I had been soaking in some filtered water. It's a little bit more soggy than I would like it to be, but that's gonna be okay. Madagascar hissing cockroaches come from Madagascar, and they like humid type conditions, so this will be beneficial for them. I don't have the containers that I used to use with my old colony. Basically, I got some old yogurt containers, cut them in half, used some sandpaper on the sides, and made little hideaways for them to hide in. I ended up throwing those out during some spring cleaning, but you know, it'll be easy. Just go buy one of those big things of yogurt and start anew. So, next step. Okay, so normally what I do is, like I said, I have those little hides for them to hide in made from yogurt containers. I don't have any right now, but I'll pick up some soon. So in the meantime, I have some egg crates. I don't recommend this because since the bedding is all wet and it's going to be somewhat humid in here, the egg crates will need to be replaced every other day or so to prevent mold and from them looking just nasty. But in the meantime, it'll do. So I have a little container down there with some water crystals. I'll grab it right here for you. That's what they basically drink out of, because if I tried putting a container of actual water in there, they would poop in it and knock it over and it would just be a big messy mess. So put the egg crates over it so they have plenty of places to hide, and I poke some holes in it so they can get through them. And here's the another container with some oatmeal and wheat bran thrown in it. Now what I like to do also on occasion is I found that they really, really, really love fish flakes. But I don't want to give it to them too much because I don't want to risk getting them sick or anything. And these are also roaches that I will not be feeding to my animals. These are pet roaches. So my husband unfortunately is not here, otherwise I'd show him helping me throw the hissers in here. So my next follow-up is going to be the hissers inside their new home. So one second. Alright, so I just decided instead of throwing them in here one by one, I just put the stuff that they were shipped in there and let them decide when they want to evacuate and start exploring, or if they just want to chill out for a while. Let's see if we can get one of them to do their trademark hissing. I find it's the males that do most of the hissing, and the females are pretty fairly quiet. I believe this is a great big fat pregnant one. She's ginormous. Also, Phoebe's losing her mind over here. She really, really, really wants to get to the hissers, but no, not for you. Let's see. Can I get you to hiss for me? No? Okay. Let's turn it over. Ooh, look, there's another. Let's see. I believe. Yep, this is a female. They don't have the horns. Let's see if I can get her to hiss. Come on. Oh, she don't want to be held, that's for sure. Well, darn, I was hoping I could get one of them to hiss, but... Oh. Well, this is pretty neat. This is not a dead one. It's one that shed, and this is their shed molt. And that's what they look like after they've shed. And I promise this isn't a... I hope it's not a dead one. Or maybe it is a dead one. I don't know. It's something. Not to worry, though. The rest of these guys are healthy. And as you can see, very fat. Let's see, maybe I can get this one to hiss. No? Okay. I'm gonna go get the other two males that were survivals from my last colony and throw them in here. Alright, so here's one of the surviving males. If you see little bugs on them, don't freak out. They're not mites or anything. Well, they're a form of mite, but they're beneficial. They actually clean the hissers. I have done a lot of reading and research on what they are, and I've been told by several sources that they're beneficial, and they don't actually hurt the hisser. Maybe I can get this guy to hiss. No? Oh, he's not interested. Come on. There you go. Let's go get the other guy.